Hello friends, it's Dee. I'm so glad to be back. I missed you very much. I took last week off, but I am looking forward to praying with you tonight. I have been feeling the weight of the need of prayer lately. In my own life, I can testify that my heart is most content when I am actively praying, and I confess I have neglected prayer lately because of many things going on in life. So, thank you. Thank you for keeping me in your thoughts, in your prayers. Me up to the Lord. I know many of you pray for me too. And so, I left a message on the community page asking for your prayer requests, asking you for your prayer requests, so I could dedicate my time to praying. So keep in mind that I have already prayed these prayers to God, and I did that as well as writing them down. So, in front of me here, I have the prayers for all of you. I prayed. I ask that you would bow your hearts with me. That you would bow your hearts with me in prayer for each other, for one another. While we come here on the internet for relaxation through Christian ASMR channel is like a double bonus, being that we can relax and unwind after a long day while being spiritually filled and reminded of God's truths in His Word. So allow me to pray in Jesus' name. Lord in heaven, God Almighty, gracious and powerful is your name. Gracious and powerful is the name of Jesus. In the midst of the chaos and noise of the world, we center in on the One who created it. We center on the One who provides peace, who provides clarity, who provides wisdom and forgiveness of sins. The One who increases love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. O Lord God, Messiah, who gives our lives purpose, I pray to you, God of the Bible, God of Israel, Enough to pay loving hands, Lord. You say, God, that work is good for mankind. Please, Lord, give us work and bless our hands, bless our work. Give us prayerful hearts and deliver us from poverty. But do not allow us to have selfish hearts. Lord, we do not want to be lustful after the things of this world, as you have told us they can entrap. The material gain can entrap and cast our eyes on worldly things. Give us heavenly minds. Give us perspective and wisdom. Fail, Lord. We cannot do anything in our flesh. Supply our needs, O God. Lord, you say in Philippians 4, and my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory. Lord, I pray for those who have been a target of violence. We hear in the news of shootings. We hear of cold-blooded murder. We hear of rape, pure wickedness. Lord, a world that has turned away from you, that questions, where is God? Where is God? When all this evil is happening, he is in plain sight. Our world has shunned God from being in our schools, in our workplaces, in media, and we see the aftermath of it, do we not? Lord, cleanse our earth. Cleanse the evil, Lord, with your piercing light. God, we pray for the families of those who have been targeted by the enemy. Lord, heal our land. Heal our land. We are all depraved without you. Lord, we have become bankrupt in morals. Lord, have your way here. Heal our families that have been mourning losses. Death is an invasion. You say, Lord, in Hebrews 10, for we know him who said, vengeance is mine, I will repay. And again, the Lord will judge his people. Lord, have mercy on their heads. I pray now for those who have been suffering from illnesses and from injuries. I pray for my dear friend. I pray for my family. Those who are struggling here. Would you heal, Lord, those who are ill? Those whose bodies are broken. Bodies break down, they get sick, our minds get sick, Lord, while the body is temporary, we know that the soul is eternal. We know that the soul is eternal, God. Please heal. Such a waste of time, God. Help us in our fear, Lord. Give us courage. Lord, fear cannot add a single second to our lives. We often fear so much that is not in our control. Lord, help my friends in their fear, in their anxiety. Them from the crippling spirit of fear, O God, in Jesus' name. Father, for those who are facing a time of mourning, mourning for lost loved ones who are grieving right now, God. Especially with Christmas here, Lord. Lord, when our soul is feeling bare, feeling desperate, it's there where we feel your presence the most. So, Lord, resonate within us when we feel we have nothing left to hold on to, when it is cold and lonely. Lord, with your presence, may take a flame in our hearts. Sitting on the sidelines of a worldly generation. Help us to speak when we should speak, and to be quiet, Lord, when we should be quiet. Help us to be the culture, Lord. Not to be afraid of the culture, but to be the difference in this world, that we may be the example. Give us hearts that are brave and courageous to open our mouths, but truly first love our neighbors. It is all meaningless if you do not love. Lord, to those who are making a difference on this earth, Lord, would you increase their reach? Spreading the gospel to the nations. Father, help us to be the lights of the world, to be salts of the earth, that we may not become stagnant Christians sitting on the sidelines in fear, that we should not be afraid of the culture, but that we should become the standard of the culture, that we should not be afraid to speak of the gospel in public. I pray, Father, that you would give us the courage to speak the truth of the gospel, but first to have love in our hearts, truly to have love in our hearts. Yes, Lord, to those who are working for you, those who are making a difference in this world for your name's sake, would you increase their reach that they may preach the gospel to the nations, O God? And to those who are broken, hungry, to those who are widowed or orphaned, Lord, may we see them. May we be the feet and the hands of Jesus, humbling ourselves and seeing others as more significant than ourselves. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hello, friends. It's Dee. I'm so glad to be back. I missed you very much. I took last week off, but I am looking forward to praying with you tonight. I have been feeling the weight of the need of prayer lately. In my own life, I can testify that is most content when I am actively praying, and I confess I have neglected prayer lately because of many things going on in life. So, thank you. Thank you for keeping me in your thoughts, in your prayers, as you lift me up to the Lord. I know many of you pray for me too. And so, I left a message on the community page asking for your prayer requests, asking you for your prayer requests, and so I could dedicate my time to praying. Keep in mind that I have already prayed these prayers to God, and I did that as well as writing them down, so in front of me here I have the prayers for all of you. I have the prayers for all of you. I prayed ASMR channel is like a double bonus, being that we can relax and unwind after a long day while being spiritually filled and reminded of God's truths in His Word. So allow me to pray in Jesus' name. Lord in heaven, God Almighty, gracious and powerful is your name. Gracious and powerful is the name of Jesus. In the midst of the chaos and noise of the world, provides wisdom and forgiveness of sins, the one who increases the fruits of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. Messiah, who gives our life's purpose, I pray to you, God of the Bible, God of Israel, God of Israel, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, Yeshua. Father, I pray for my friends, my dear friends. I pray for them now, Lord, in your name. Give us wisdom. Lord God, give us wisdom and knowledge. Give us great discernment, O Lord. single soul whose heart is crying out for prayer. Be with them, Lord. Be with my friend dear. Meet with them wherever they are in their lives, that they may see your glory. They may see the glory of God. Lord, we pray for this world. That has failed to protect the lives of the innocent, the lives of the unborn. A world that is neck deep in self-love and self-gratification, oh God. We forget our brothers and sisters. Oh God, protect the unborn, protect those who cannot protect themselves, Lord God. We know that everything the Lord creates is good. His design is perfect. But our world has fallen. Struggling just to make ends meet. Those who have lost jobs. Those who have tried everything and yet are still facing financial struggle. Lord, I'm reminded in Proverbs 30 where it says, Lord, give us enough. Enough. It says, lest I be full and deny. Lest I be full and deny thee and say, who is the Lord? Or lest I be poor and steal and take the name of my God in vain. Lord, give us enough. Give us enough. Many seek prosperity, material gain, and wealth. The temptation is there for all of us, friends. But we pray that God would give us enough, that we wouldn't have to steal, but not too much, that we forget where our bread comes from. And Lord, forgive me. Forgive me if I have put my trust in any material. Lord, forgive us if we have put our trust in anything but you. Lord, when you withhold riches from us, bless us. Bless us richly in our hearts. In our hearts. That we do not feel void from belongings. Give us enough to pay for what we owe and to provide for our loved ones. Provide for our loved ones. Give us working hands, Lord. You say, God, that work is good for mankind. Please, Lord, give us work and bless our hands, bless our work. Give us prayerful hearts and deliver us from poverty. But do not allow us to have selfish hearts that falls into prosperity. Lord, we do not want to be lustful after the things of this world, as you have told us. Material gain can entrap and cast our eyes on worldly things. Give us heavenly minds. Give us perspective and wisdom, Lord God. Jesus, Jesus. Leave us not to our flesh, or we will fail, Lord. We cannot do anything in our shootings. We hear of cold-blooded murder. We hear of rape, pure wickedness. Lord, a world that has turned away from you, that questions, where is God? Where is God when all this evil is happening? You say, Lord, in Hebrews 10, for we know him who said, vengeance is mine, I will repay. And again, the Lord will judge his people. Lord, have mercy on their heads. Bodies break down, they get sick, our minds get sick. Lord, while the body is temporary, we know that the soul is eternal. the soul is eternal, God, please heal both body and soul. Heal both body and soul. Riddled with illness, body and soul, riddled with illness. And we are all going to go. We are all going to go at some point. So, Father, be with us in the fear and the anxiety of it all. Give us courage. Give us courage and confidence. I pray for those who are feeling lost, my friends who are feeling uncertain about many things in life. We know, Lord, that you are unchanging, that you are an unchanging God who is sovereign over all things. Be a lamp unto our feet. This direction when we don't know what to do. And in the waiting, Lord, give us patience that we may not just look to the future as a dark and uncertain place, but that we would have great hope and that we would have firm feet on a solid truths of our Lord, and that he gives us real joy, does he not? We are hungry for too many things, my friends, me included. So I pray that in our sufferings, in our afflictions, in our illness, that we would rely on the Lord, that we would wait on him. We are feeling lost, that we would wait on him. Oh God, though we walk in darkness for some time, be a lamp unto our feet and light the way. You know the course, Lord, you know the course. Guide us that we may do your will. The Lord says in Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. Lord, for my friends who are struggling with deep anxiety, fear, depression, anger, anything, Lord, that is not from you. Anything, Lord, that is not profitable our soul and to our relationship with you and one another. Give us a firm foundation of peace and a wellspring of joy that we can drink from, Lord. Father, fear is such a crippling spirit. Fear is such a crippling thing. Fear stunts our growth, our gratitude, our mindfulness for what we have. Lord, it stunts our hope. And it is such a waste of time, God. Help us in our fear, Lord. Give us courage. Lord, fear cannot add a single second to our lives. We often fear so much that is not in our control. Lord, help my friends in their fear, in their anxiety. Release them from the crippling spirit of fear, O God, in Jesus' name. Father, for those who are facing a time of mourning, for lost loved ones who are grieving right now, God, a especially with Christmas here, Lord. Lord, when our soul is feeling bare, feeling desperate, it's there where we feel your presence the most. So, Lord, resonate within us when we feel we have nothing left to hold on to, when it is cold and lonely. Lord, would your presence may take a flame in our hearts and warm us, Lord. Oh Lord, for those that do have family, help them to be God-glorifying families. Let them be richly blessed with your word and your spirit, that they may raise this next generation to be God-fearing and God-honoring. And Lord, help us to be lights in this dark world. Help us to be salt of the earth. Salt of the earth, that we may not be stagnant Christians sitting on the sidelines of a worldly generation. Help us to speak when we should speak, and to be quiet, Lord, when we should be quiet. Help us to be the culture, Lord, not to be afraid of the culture, us hearts that are brave and courageous to open our mouths, but truly first love our neighbors. It is all meaningless if you do not love. Lord, to those who are making a difference on this earth, Lord, would you increase their reach, spreading the gospel to the nations. Father, help us to be the lights of the world, to be salts of the earth, that we may not become stagnant Christians sitting on the sidelines in fear, that we should not be afraid of the culture, but that we should become the standard of the culture, that we should not be afraid to speak of the gospel in public. I pray, Father, that you would give us the courage to speak the truth of the gospel, but first to have love in our hearts, truly to have love in our hearts. Yes, Lord, to those who are working for you, those who are making a difference in this world for your name's sake, would you increase their reach, that they may preach the gospel to the nations, O God. And to those who are broken, hungry, to those who are widowed or orphaned, Lord, may we see them. May we be the feet and the hands of Jesus, humbling ourselves and seeing others more significant than ourselves. In Jesus' name.